Hello, I'm at Rockscape, and in the background there we've got a big Vavette tanker with 36 metre Vogelslang dribble bars on, and that has a capacity of 40 cube. And they are playing liquid digestate onto the wheat here at Rockscape.
And I've just speeded up the opening of the dribble bars, just so you can see what that looks like. And then it will stop here, but they do then fold a little bit further out, which you'll see on a further clip.
And it just arrived into the country, this machine, last week.
Now, this is a class cab by the looks of it to me. I'm not sure which one it's from, but maybe if you know, you could tell us in the comments below. That'd be great.
And here is the first tractor and tanker load, and it's just going to connect on. And it'll take two of these, and it still won't quite be full. Moving on into position where he will start the dribble bars.
Now, I know the ground is firming up this time of year, but we've still had a hell of a lot of rain, and I was really impressed with the way this machine travelled all across the land. And I'd mentioned that this had just arrived in the country last week, and I believe this is the very first one that Vavette have made, so this will be the first one effectively in the world of this specific setup from them. And I've just pulled up the J. Riley Beet Harvesters webpage, which is where this machine came from, and a few key stats. So this is a 13-litre, 550-horsepower, six-cylinder Volvo Penta engine, and it produces a whopping 2,650 newton metres of torque at just 1,200 RPM. And Hislop and Sons are contractors based out of Melton Mowbray area, and they cover Leicestershire, Nottinghamshire and the South Lincolnshire areas.
Empty now, so he's heading back up the field to swap over to a different one. This is only a small field, so it didn't take long to do. And here's one of the next trailers tanking in with the Fendt 724 and the Connor 4500T. Down it goes. And they'll start the pumps off to empty. It's some setup. Those tankers are now empty. is ready to take another load. Just back at Rockscape, and this is the lagoon where they are tanking from. So this is where it pumps out of the lagoon, which is here. And that is where all the digestate that comes from the AD plant gets stored, and that's the liquid side of it, and the solids, they're stored in a separate area that gets spread back onto the land with the traditional muck spreaders.
And here you can see a clip of that solid digestate being spread onto the land, and here's Johnny in the Zerion, and he's just working that in. Those keen-eyed amongst you may notice in the distance there were a couple of trees in this field. They were bringing the telehandlers down to remove those, but we just wanted to get some footage while I was down there, so hence they set off and that got sorted.
What an absolute monster of a machine that was. God, I loved it. I absolutely get such a buzz out of going to see all the different kit. Monsters, small, old, doesn't matter what it is, I just love it. Big thank you for all the comments on the last video with Johnny. It was great to read those, and it was great to be back in cab and with him as well. So yeah, thanking you, and I'll see you on that next video.